Welcome to TalkNorth.com. Thanks to our longtime producer, Brandon Morton. Please download before you listen. If you'd like to advertise with us, you can reach us at TalkNorthPodcast@gmail.com. And please follow us on Twitter at TalkNorthPod. Two promo codes to be aware of. BiteSquad.com, use the promo code TalkNorth to get your first delivery free. And go to SodaStick.com, the great local apparel company. Use the promo code YouBetcha to get free shipping on any sized order. Jeff Diamond is the former NFL Executive of the Year, former General Manager of the Vikings, former President of the Tennessee Titans, and he is the host and the star of Jeff Diamond's Vikings and NFL Insider, part of the TalkNorth.com podcast network. Thanks to our sponsors, White Bear Lake Superstore and B52 Burgers and Brew. Thanks to our producer, Brandon Morton, and please follow us on Twitter at TalkNorthPod. We have some interesting stuff coming down the pike in the future. You can also find all of our shows across the network at that address, so check it out. Jeff, let's get right to the Patrick Mahomes mystery. We are recording this on Wednesday. We don't know whether he will play on Sunday or not. So let's ask the question, should he play, given he's not far removed from a dislocated knee, given that the Chiefs probably are going to make the playoffs, whether or not he plays in this game, and given that he's facing a very difficult front seven in the Vikings?
I think it's a tough decision for Andy Reid, the coach of the Chiefs, to make. And if he's very close to 100%, I would play him because I think that they need to kind of reverse their recent fortune where they've lost three of the last four and all at home, including last week, 31-24 to the Packers. And so, although the offense wasn't necessarily the problem as much last week as the defense was against Green Bay, but I think if you have an opportunity to get a win at home against a playoff contender such as the Vikings, if I'm in Andy Reid's shoes, I'm going to play Patrick Mahomes. Now, another mitigating factor can be the offensive line in Kansas City has been banged up. Eric Fisher, the starting left tackle, Andrew Wiley, starting left guard, both missed the Packer game. And if they're not ready to go, then that would kind of influence me to perhaps want to sit him out in this particular game. And so we'll see how it shakes out. But I would anticipate, from what we're hearing out of Kansas City, he probably will not play this week and come back next week. But I wouldn't be shocked if he did play too, because I've seen that happen before in the past. And I remember many years ago, mid-80s, we were playing, when I was with the Vikings, we were playing the Bears at the Metrodome. And all week it was, oh, Jim McMahon's out. He's not going to play. He's not going to play. And we're up two touchdowns in the second half. You may remember that game, Jim.
Yep.
And McMahon comes off the bench, throws three touchdown passes, two of them to Willie Gault, and we get beat. I think it was a Monday night game, too. And so I never put it past a team to kind of lay in the woods and in the weeds, and all of a sudden, here comes their star player, and he comes out and has a great game. So I'm sure the Vikings and Mike Zimmer and the defense are preparing for both Patrick Mahomes and Matt Moore, who, by the way, has been fairly effective. And he was 24-36 against Green Bay for 267, two touchdowns, no interceptions. He's been playing pretty good, too, pretty well against Denver the week before. So he's no slouch, but he's not the reigning league MVP.
Right. And as someone who's been in these meetings, when we see that happen, when we see somebody downplayed or ruled out and they end up playing on Sunday, how often do you think that is subterfuge, and how often do you think it's just something changed? Either the guy felt better or a game situation dictated it.
Yeah, I think that it can go either way. And it will be interesting to see the injury report as it comes out this week and see if he practiced or if he was limited in practice, which is what we anticipate. And then come Friday when they determine whether he's questionable, whether he's out. And if he's still questionable on Friday, then I'd be a little more concerned if I were the Vikings. If he's doubtful, or obviously if he's out, he's out. And they're not going to make a change there. But I would anticipate he'll be questionable. I think that the Chiefs and Andy Reid would like to keep the Vikings guessing and preparing for both guys, even though I don't know that things change that much in terms of their scheme and their offense and the weapons that they've got. And I'm talking about Tyreek Hill as one of the game-breaking receivers. I'm talking about Travis Kelce, all-pro tight end. You've got Sammy Watkins, when he's healthy, is a dynamic receiver. And they've got several other big-time players that can contribute on offense. And so it's going to be a big challenge either way for the Vikings. Kansas City comes in with the number five defense in the league and number one last year, as I said. But the Vikings are playing pretty well offensively, too, and have a much better defense this year. I think, to me, the key factor in the game and the key mismatch in this game is the Vikings running game, which is ranked number three in the league, 160 yards a game. Dalvin Cook leading the NFL in rushing with 823 yards, leading with 9 rushing TDs against the Kansas City rush defense. That's number 30 in the league.
Mm-hmm.
And has had a lot of trouble this year. Has given up, I think, 4 100-yard rushers and also had a lot of difficulty in the passing game against Green Bay with the backs out of the backfield. Aaron Jones had 7 catches for 159 yards and 2 touchdowns for Green Bay last Sunday in that game. And the Packer running back scored 4 touchdowns in the ball game as they won.
Yeah, absolutely. I actually think this is a fairly good, you know, given that we came into the season thinking that playing at Kansas City was going to be a really tough matchup. I think actually in terms of football and in terms of the Chiefs' record to date, they're 1-3 at home. It's not as daunting a matchup as we thought. We'll do our pick on this game later. But before we get to what you thought of the Vikings against Washington, let us go ahead and say thank you to White Bear Lake Superstore. You can find all of your deals at whitebearlakesuperstore.com.
Yeah, Jim, thanks. And always excited to talk about the White Bear Lake Superstore, Buick GMC, and my good friend, the owner, Paul Rubin, his general manager, Charlie Gattrell. They're great staff. Minnesota's number one volume Buick GMC dealer, 5 years running, with the best selection and the only place to get the premium experience. And the White Bear Lake Superstore has all kinds of great specials on their website, whitebearlakesuperstore.com. If you go to the website, you'll see $3,250 purchase allowance on select 2019 Buick Enclaves, $4,000 purchase allowance on select 2019 Buick Encores and Buick Envisions, and a $5,000 purchase bonus cash on select 2019 GMC Sierra 1500s. Great vehicles. The White Bear Lake Superstore also is the Quigley 4x4 Van Superstore, and they are a certified elite dealer. Only 7% of GM dealers make the cut. So visit in person at 3900 Highway 61 North in White Bear Lake or online at whitebearlakesuperstore.com for all your vehicle needs and the premium experience. Buick GMC, we are professional grade. They have great pre-owned specials on the lot and rebates on tires. So check it out, White Bear Lake Superstore and whitebearlakesuperstore.com.
Did you learn anything from the Vikings' victory over Washington last Thursday night?
Well, I thought it was really kind of a interesting game from the standpoint that, and we had Eric Kendricks, the Vikings' leading tackler, middle linebacker, having a terrific season. We had him on our Monday Night Purple show on WCCO Radio this week, talking about the Washington game, looking at the Kansas City. And I asked Eric, I said, have you ever played in a game where you only had 41 defensive snaps? And he said, I don't think so, not in the NFL. And so that was pretty amazing, the ball control that the Vikings had in that game, even though the score was only a 10-point game. But in terms of ball control, the Vikings had a tremendous advantage, 36 minutes to 24. And we know that they could have easily scored another touchdown or field goal to run the score up a little bit more. And so, but I think what really jumped out to me was the ball control for that Vikings offense. And that starts with the running game and Dalvin Cook and having another big day, 98 yards rushing. He had 73 yards receiving, another rushing touchdown. And Stephon Diggs, his fine recent play, although he's still coughing up the football, which has to change, and in a hurry, because as the competition is getting tougher now, those fumbles are definitely going to hurt the cause. And he has 4 fumbles this year, Diggs does, and which leads the NFL. And then, of course, the other interesting aspect of this game was that Adam Thielen missed the game. And will he be back for Kansas City? BC Johnson had a couple catches in the game, did fine, and a little more use of the tight ends with Thielen out and Irv Smith Jr., another three catches, as did Kyle Rudolph in this game against Washington. So overall, defensively, a stout effort. I think the game changed significantly when Case Keenum went out because he was playing pretty well when he was in the ball game in his return after the Minneapolis Miracle. And Adrian Peterson, the guy still got some ability, kind of surprising, but he's still a tough customer out there, tough to bring down, and he had a pretty good game too. So that was impressive to see him run in this ball game. But overall, the Vikings defense shut him down in the second half, only allowing a field goal. So it was a good game that they needed. Kirk Cousins for his confidence to win a primetime game and improve that kind of dreadful record that he had going in, which was 5-13. Now he's 6-13 in primetime, and he'll have another opportunity come another week from Sunday when he goes to Dallas.
What are you getting out of Kirk Cousins these days? He's coming off a spectacular month statistically, won 4 straight games. What kind of vibe are you getting from him?
It was interesting to hear him talk during his media session this week and talking about that, yeah, they're in good position at 6-2, but he certainly realizes and talked about it that the story and the narrative, as he likes to use that term, for the season will be told over these last 8 weeks and then hopefully on into the playoffs. So he knows that the sledding is going to get tougher starting this week in Kansas City, then going to Dallas, got a Monday night date in Seattle coming up and a Sunday nighter if they don't flex it out against the Chargers. So 4 difficult road games, although the Chargers may or may not be in contention by then, but Seattle certainly will be, and so will Dallas and Kansas City. And then, of course, those final 2 home games against Green Bay and Chicago. So it's really, I think, now game on as far as and Cousins recognizes that. He talked about it, and he took it straight down. He said, I know that the challenges are there starting this week. And so I think that's refreshing to hear a player even talk about more than just the game right in front of him, which is always kind of player speak and coach speak. And Cousins was actually talking about, we know the second half of the season is going to be tough.
Yeah, and it's going to be fascinating to watch him because he's playing his absolute best, and he is going to be under the microscope in all these games. Let's get to the NFC North and a couple other topics and make our pick. I do want to thank B52 Burgers and Brew, where Jeff does his Monday night show.
Yeah, Jim, definitely. And as I mentioned, had a great show with Eric Kendricks the other night and Tyler Conklin, the number 3 tight end, who's playing a lot, played, I think, 43% of the snaps the other day against Washington. And so with this 3 tight end offense, so Tyler Conklin was there with Eric at the show and had a great turnout at B52 Burgers and Brew in Inver Grove Heights, and a terrific restaurant. They have 25 varieties of burgers that are fantastic. They have great entrees and appetizers. I had the fish tacos that I loved, and B52 will have Monday night specials, a fun rooftop patio when the weather is okay, and they have a fantastic Sunday brunch. And they are located in Inver Grove Heights, 5 minutes from Viking headquarters in Eagan. And they are, as I said, the new home of our Monday Night Purple show live on News Talk 830 WCCO radio this year. And next Monday night, November 4th, will be Harrison Smith will be returning to the show. And looking forward to seeing Harrison and talking about facing that prolific Chiefs offense and looking ahead to the Dallas Cowboys game coming up the next Sunday night on national TV. And we'll have a second player guest there too that I co-host with Joe Anderson. And so we talk about the previous game, hit NFL hot topics, and look ahead to the next game, get to know the players better. And that's Monday Night Purple on WCCO Radio. So hope everybody comes out to B52 Burgers and Brew and check out their website, b52burgersandbrew.com, and hope to see you there.
If I said in August that there's going to be an NFC North team that's going to have a real problem at quarterback and kicker, we might have guessed Vikings. Instead, it's the Bears.
Well, we might have guessed the Bears, too.
Yeah, true.
They certainly had their kicking woes last year. although Trubisky had a pretty good year,